Dungeon Hack Level 11. Character level 15. We have every level of spell available to us. We are a walking, holy, divine monster. And we have a snake monster to kill. A really creepy looking snake monster. Wow. Is that... That's not the Medusa, is it? It's... Well, let's find out. Oh, that was a spirit naga. Not to be confused with... Bone naga. Interesting. Well, it hit me and it didn't seem to poison me or anything, so... Hopefully it won't be that much of a threat. Let's go ahead and do all my buffs, since I didn't do that after the last time I rested. Hold on to my rations for an emergency, in case I get cursed and find myself unable to rest or anything. What's this? Oh, a citrine. Oh wait, do I have any... Wait. Oh, the helmet I threw actually went down the stairs. That's awesome. I didn't know that happened. But yeah, screw that ponytail helmet. I'll hang on to my gold helmet. Spirit Nagas seem like they might be evil. I mean, they certainly look evil. Or is it Naga? See, that's another one of those. I just don't know. Alright, that's it for buffs, right? Oh, I still have a True Seeing in effect, so... No reason to do that yet. So I have a Sol's Searing Orb, which I'm going to have to remember next time. I have to drop my hammer temporarily to use that. And I have Firestorm, which I'm pretty sure is just a one-time cast. Alright, re-equip my shield. Do I have any keys I want to drop so I don't get confused? Yeah, I want to drop that one, and I guess that's it. I still have a wand I haven't even tried yet. I'm not going to use these staffs. I might use this Ring of Strength at some point. I don't know, probably not, but might as well hang on to it. What kind of potions do I have? Confusion and invisibility. Nice. Chime. You know what? Well, I'll wait until there's a door that I don't have a key for. Alright, the citrine was on this level, so I definitely need to take that with me. I was going to just say screw it, let's see what these chimes do, but I might as well wait until they might potentially actually be useful. Oh hey, a green mallet. I want to throw this at the slithering... Oh my god, what was that? Is that like a... Oh, I bet that's like a black pudding or something. That's not good. Don't those things eat your equipment? Oh, maybe I spoke too soon about the enemies getting too easy. Come on, hammer. Okay, I killed it. What was that? Living muck. Apparently three of them have died on this level. So not as bad as a black pudding, I don't think. Because I'm pretty sure black pudding is just wreck your armor. They spit some sort of corrosive thing. But on the other hand, that might not even do anything to magic armor. Well, I guess my actual armor isn't magical, though. It's just really good plate mail. So, if that was a black pudding, I might have to worry. Oh yeah, I guess I need to actually bring this mallet with me. Not just toss it into living mucks. I think it's the black pudding I'm thinking of. There might be some other similar enemy, like a black ooze or something. Pretty sure I never actually encountered a living muck in any Dungeons & Dragons game before. Alright, so that was another tingling sensation. That's not just what the teleporter... Oh, you know what? That might just be the teleporter message that I never noticed before. Oh wait, no, because it specifically says I don't feel the tingling anymore. So I don't know. Alright, there were a lot of enemies in that room, so I'm going to have to manage this pretty carefully. slow and steady wins the race. Or slow and steady kills the Mux. And the Naugus. Pretty sure it's Naga. So, not much else to talk about since yesterday's video. Still trucking along at work. I don't have the boom key yet, I don't guess. Well, here we go. Here is our opportunity to see what these chimes do. Okay, so using Chimes of Hunger definitely does not identify the item, because that's the second time this happened to me. So next time we know, don't use unidentified chimes. Or just use them. I mean, it's not like it's that big of a deal. I do have Create Food and Water. A couple days ago from my video description, I said the description as "Whoa, whoa, living on a prayer," which, if you are familiar with 1980s butt rock, it's probably a refrain you're familiar with. And the reason I made that the description is I thought it was apropos because that was when I reached level 9, so I was halfway there. And the second reason is because my character is literally living on a prayer. I mean, I'm praying for the food and water and the healing spells that are keeping me alive. So, holy crap. Alright. These living mucks are nothing to muck around with. So yeah, that was a clever little double meaning then. Well, I thought it was clever. What the? That's weird. There's not a wall here, but okay. Obviously that was because I had true seeing in effect. So that wall just does not even show up as a wall. See, I thought it just alerted me to the location of hidden doors. I didn't know I could actually see the door for what it was. That's interesting. True seeing is a pretty handy spell. I kind of underestimated it at the time. But someone in the comments pointed out that, I'm held. Damn. I guess I'm going to have to start getting free action. Man, that is a nasty enemy. Takes forever to kill, does a ton of damage, paralyzes you, makes just a disgusting sound. Where'd it go? I guess the hammer killed it on the way back. Nice. Good job, hammer. Don't have the bullhorn yet. And not the kind of bullhorn that I would make an announcement with. Because I don't have anything to announce just yet. Stay tuned, though. Big, major announcement coming soon. That's not true. I don't know why I said that. I don't have any announcement. I mean, the announcement will be at the end. It's not this, is it? No. At the end of Dungeon Hack, the announcement will be coming soon. Super House of Dead Ninjas, because that's the next game that was requested. And I'm looking forward to that. It's like a sort of an action roguelike platformer game, it looks like. It's by Adult Swim Games, who, man, you wouldn't think of Adult Swim as like a big name in the indie gaming scene. Ouch. But they've released a lot of awesome stuff recently. I'm held again. Dang it. I guess I should. Maybe I should go on ahead and rest and get free action. I'm not sure. Didn't Adult Swim also? They also did another recent big indie game, but I can't think of which one at the moment. An unknown force quenches the spell's energy. What? No. That's exactly what I need in this game. Something that makes it so my magic doesn't work. So does my true seeing not? Oh, I bet that's what the strange tingling is. That's a zone where magic doesn't work. Am I right? I don't know. Let's try it. Soul Searing Orb. It looks like that's what that is. Good job. Ow. I am in trouble. Holy crap. Okay. I can probably rest in the spot I'm in. Alright. Do I want to change up my spell? Oh, yeah. I guess I could cast Firestorm on that guy. But not when I'm so low on health. Do I have any more healing spells? Just Cure Light, which at this point I might as well not even get Cure Light Wounds anymore, right? It's barely worth using. Yeah, I'm just gonna rest. I'm not gonna push my luck. Alright, which level was free? Oh yeah, level 4. Well, I guess I don't need neutralized poisons on this level, so I'll just take free action. I get one neutralized poison. I guess I have heal, so I don't really need it. Okay. Because I thought there might be like a poison dart trap or something that I might have to deal with. You never know. Things are starting to get kind of dicey. Of course, I said that like 3 levels ago. And then I'd be the next 3 levels, no problem. So I guess dicey is a relative term. Alright. Alright, you living muck. I'm not through with you yet. And I missed again. Great. Firestorm. It didn't kill it. Wow. It's still not dead, even after I hit it with a firestorm. Child of a pooch. Okay. So, I just want to confirm something. A strange tingling just went up my spine. Cure Light Wounds. An unknown form. Okay, so that's definitely what that is. The game calls that a magical zone, and you have the option to turn it on or off when you go into the customized menu. And when I was a kid, I never knew what magical zones were, and I figured it was something good. But that's not the case. Maple wand. Alright, let's find out what some of these wands I haven't identified yet do. I have a maple wand and a cedar wand. So yeah, that's a magical zone. It's a zone where magic does not work. Wand of paralyzation, nice. Shouldn't that be wand of paralysis? That's kind of a wand of curing, interesting. Well, I'm gonna need that in a minute because I am almost dead. Again. Oh, great. I just know I'm going to get myself into a situation where it's life or death if I don't cast some sort of healing spell. And I'm in a magical quenching zone. It's bound to happen. Which, I mean, that's bad news for a cleric. I didn't even do my routine. I don't know. Getting a little sick of the routine, to be honest. After all this time. Doing the same sequence over and over again every time I rest. But, I mean, I'm getting my butt kicked even when I do that. So, I need to... oh, yeah. I forgot to cast free action, too. Alright, Mux. I might be ready for you. Oh yeah, I should probably equip my shield again too. So many things to keep track of. My stars. Wow. Okay, I have found a new candidate for the worst enemy in the game. This might be the longest video yet. Because these black mucks just seem to have a ridiculous number of hit points. And they're tough enough that I have to periodically strategically retreat. Or stretreat, as nobody should say, ever. At least these Nagas don't seem to do anything serious. I mean, other than creep me out and give me nightmares. I'm not a fan of snakes. I mean, I'm not so afraid of them that seeing a snake in a video game would freak me out. Because I know some people are that way about spiders. Like, there's a mod for Skyrim that specifically replaces all of the spiders in the game with bears. For people who are so arachnophobic that even seeing a video game spider freaks them out. I'm glad I don't have that serious of a phobia. I mean, I do have some phobias, but not, they're not like debilitating. Like, I have a pretty bad phobia. Oh my god. I have a bad phobia of living mucks who do 22 points of damage to me. Let me tell you. I don't even know what kind of phobia that is. I don't know what kind of Greek suffixes and prefixes you use for that one. But no, I have a pretty bad phobia of stinging insects, like bees and wasps and hornets and all that. And there was just a gigantic wasp at my house the other day. And I was pretty freaked out. It was in my living room. I was in the kitchen getting me something to eat. And I came back into the living room and I saw the giant wasp on the wall. And I went back into the kitchen, you know, to hide from it. And I wasn't sure what to do because, I mean, it got me at a time of great vulnerability, you know. Always go after your enemies when they're eating or on the toilet. Those are the two times they're the most vulnerable. I want to see something. Oh yeah, that's right. So, okay, so this is a non-magical potion. Let's see what it is. Okay, so that's the that tastes awful potion. So I don't know, that might just be water, and it's like old water, and that's why it says it tastes awful. Or I might have made my saving throw versus poison. I'm not sure. But anyway, to continue my riveting wasp story, I threw a shirt at it, like a dirty shirt, and I trapped the wasp under the shirt. And then after it was trapped, I squashed it with my shoe. I wasn't wearing the shoe at the time. I picked up my shoe and I squashed it that way, because I didn't want to step on it and risk it flying up onto my leg if it turns out that I didn't get the wasp all the way under the shirt. Yeah, I'm pretty freaked out by them, but I managed to kill it. And the worst thing is, I live alone. Like, I don't have roommates or anything anymore, so I couldn't even show off my awesome wasp killing skills. But oh well, felt like a victory nonetheless. You know, this would be a lot less annoying if it didn't always spit me out of that teleporter facing south. I know I've complained about that before, but it's really kind of a pain in the ass. Alright, sorry, I already used my Firestorm and my Soul-Searing Orb, I guess. These things don't seem to want to go through these teleporters at all. They're showing a great deal of intelligence by just lying in wait for me. So wait, what happens if I step through the teleporter and throw my hammer? Does it? Yeah, I guess it does. It comes back through the teleporter. Level 16, woot! Man, it's just handing the levels out like candy now. So I wonder if I, now that I have the highest level spells, I mean, I assume I keep getting more, like a larger quantity of spells of each level, like I have been. But just Firestorm and Restoration are the two most powerful spells. I'm never gonna find anything more powerful than those. So how many points do I have now? 77? That's pretty good. Oops. Okay, so yeah, I do get more of these lower level spells. Man, it almost seems not worth it to get all these Cure Light Wounds, but I don't know what else I would get. Yeah, let's try Whole Person, I guess. I mean, there's really no point in me getting more Spiritual Hammers or more copies of the spell Aid. I almost said more Aids, but that's not something I should say. Magical Vestment, I guess? I don't know. Oh yeah, I was curious about Remove Paralysis. I wonder if I can actually use that when I'm paralyzed. Probably not, but otherwise, why would it be in there? And I have one more of these available. Nice. I think I'll get another heal. That's a very... Oops, not harm. It's a very useful spell to have multiple copies of. I think I said more aids in one of my previous videos, but nobody noticed it. Which means I probably shouldn't point it out, but I'm sure at some point someone down the line will watch the video and be like, haha, he said aids. So, making slow progress here. I mean, those living mucks are slowing me down quite a bit. More than the trolls were. But I guess last level was so easy that it has to mix things up a little bit. Alright, let's see if I can actually get some use out of that Searing Orb spell this time. Oh, there's that Bone Key. I can go on ahead and take care of that door. Yes! I don't know why you can't just throw the key at the lock. I mean, that works in real life, right? I mean, that's how I unlock my door when I get home from work. I just toss my keychain in the general direction of the doorknob. It'll work itself out. Oh, hey, there's one of those horns. And there's the other one. It's the matching set. Well, no, because they're both facing the same way. Plate mail. Magical plate mail. That's probably better than what I have. That is one better than what I have. I'll take it. And with the shield, I am now at -6. Assuming I can remember to keep my shield equipped. Boy, times like this, you just need a third hand, don't you? It's too bad I'm not playing Munchkin. There's all kinds of stuff in that game that gives you a third hand. Well, I guess there's just a couple cards that do. One of my favorite items in Munchkin is the three-handed sword. That's a good sword. It's like +10, but you can only use it if you have a card that gives you a third hand. Or if you have a cheat card. That'll work too. Of course, it's not as good as firearms. Firearms gives you... It's one of those spots of confusion. Interesting. Wee, I'm having fun. But yeah, firearms gives you like +5 for every empty hand you have. So if you have more than two hands, it can get pretty broken. Pretty fast. Of course, Munchkin is a game all about being broken, obviously. I don't know, I liked Munchkin at first. I bought like the first 6 expansions or something like that, and I have a ton of Munchkin cards, but it's a game you can't really go back to that often. Oh yeah, I have that bullhorn now, so I can go ahead and unlock this door. I don't know. Munchkin, at some point, it just becomes whoever can get lucky enough to draw monsters first. If you never played it, Munchkin is basically, it's a card game that's sort of D&D light, I guess. Like, you have a deck of cards that are door cards, and every time your turn comes around, you flip up one of the cards over to represent kicking down a door. And there can be a monster behind the door, or there can be a trap, or there can be some kind of special event. And the point is to be the first one to get to level 10. Or level 21 if you're playing Epic Munchkin. And every time you kill a monster, you get treasure, and the treasure just it gets pretty ridiculous pretty quickly. So at some point, it just becomes a matter of hoping you draw a monster, because at some point you have so much treasure and so much just broken equipment that you can kill anything that comes your way. So it's just a matter of killing monsters as quickly as possible. And since, I mean, it's a card game, so it's totally random. For a second, I thought I dropped my holy symbol. Alright. Searing Orb. Let's go. Let's actually do it this time. Miss. Alright. Firestorm. Alright. There's another one of these mucks up the stairs from me, so I can't really retreat. Fortunately, that small boost on my armor class seems... Well, I guess I spoke too soon. I might... Okay. I was going to say, I might have to teleport the monster away, but I dealt with it. So yeah, I think I just need to build my Munchkin deck more smartly, because I'm pretty much just using all the cards I have in the deck. Or decks. There's a door deck and a treasure deck. And I'm just using everything, because the game doesn't really give you any deck building guidelines or anything. Like, it doesn't say, okay, this is a ratio of monsters to traps to special events to modifiers. Cause there are spells or cards that can modify, like, give an enemy +5, so if your opponent's fighting the enemies, you can screw them over. But the people I play with tend to be pretty competitive, which I'm not really that competitive, so I kind of hold off on using any of the screw your opponent over cards until the last possible minute, where if I don't use them, they'll win. And it kind of makes for a predictable game. Because, you know, I'm the kind of person... See, this is why I don't really play competitive games that much, because I just don't like... I don't like people being mad at me and trash-talking me and stuff, and getting visibly pissed off. So, I kind of rather just lose and not play optimally than have to deal with that. Wonder what my... Oh, it's +3 now. Okay. So, the Spiritual Hammer does not... go up in power as often as I would like it to. But still seems to be doing okay. Except against these living mucks. Alright, is there a secret door or anywhere in here? Kinda wanna make sure there's nothing left in here before I call it quits. That's just a weird looking wall. Huh. I thought that might indicate there was some kind of secret here, but it doesn't look like it. But yeah, my favorite kind of competitive games are games like Dominion, the deck-building card game, where you can't really screw your opponents over. I mean, there are attack cards, but usually the group I play with don't really use the attack cards. We just kind of try to build the best deck we can. It's basically like multiplayer solitaire. Which, I don't know, that makes it sound dumber than it is. It's actually really fun. Dominion is a super fun game, and I highly recommend it. And if you have an Android device, as I now do, you can get Androminion, which is like a fan-made Android single-player version of Dominion, where you can play against bots and stuff. It's a lot of fun. It's kind of the fun of Magic the Gathering without having to constantly buy new cards. I mean, you can buy the base set of Dominion cards and have fun with it for a pretty long time without having to buy any of the expansions. Alright, well, I'm missing something. What am I missing? Okay, there are two doors here I haven't been through yet. One of them is probably the bullhorn door. The bull door. Thought I saw something. Never mind. Now, which teleporter do I want to go through? That's the question. I think it's one of these two. If I remember correctly, which is very unlikely. Oh, I did remember correctly. Excellent. So yeah, traditional tabletop games are fun. Once in a while. I prefer video games. I like a good single player video game experience. That's just kind of the way I'm wired. I mean, multiplayer games can be fun, but I don't know. I like being able to set my own pace in a video game, which I can't always do in multiplayer games. I like being able to play whenever I want, which I can't always do in multiplayer games. Like if I have a regular gaming group to play something with, like if I say I played. I mean, we try to do this at some point, have like a regular Terraria group, and you know, the way I play games, I'm not that likely to jump onto the Terraria server that often, because I don't want to get like, I don't want to like disappoint people when I want to stop playing, and I don't like gaming to feel like an obligation, I guess. Oil of Fiery Burning, nice. I didn't realize I identify one of those. Which, I mean, not saying that when I do play multiplayer games with people, it's an obligation. I mean, like I said, I have fun. But, you know, if I decide I want to stop playing, and the other people I'm playing with don't want to stop playing, then it can cause some friction. And I'm very anti-friction. The Wraith is immune to normal weapons. And even the... apparently he died in the middle of writing that sentence. They forgot the ARG! Whatever you do, watch out for the beast of ARG! That's a Monty Python reference for you. So yeah, multiplayer gaming, fun, but stressful. Not stressful. You know, I whine entirely too much. I don't know why you guys put up with it. Oh hey, non-magical boots. I bet these are good. They are... Did they actually teleport? No. I thought the boots might, or items might teleport when you throw them through the teleporter, but I guess not. I guess that's just the spiritual hammer that does that, since it's special and it always comes back to you. Alright, so one of these teleporters I haven't been through yet, right? Okay, I need to go through this top one again. There we go. Because I haven't been through this door. Hi, Naga. Hi again, Naga. You know, I hate to nag you, but I think you need to die. I know. Not fair of me. But you know, that's the way dungeons work. I throw the hammer and you die. That's the arrangement. I mean, it's not like I'm some sort of cold-blooded killer. I mean, I'm killing you for a very good reason. There's some sort of orb somewhere in this dungeon, apparently, that some lady wants. And she said there lies gold and gem enough for any man, but, you know, I don't have enough gold and gem. I mean, I might have enough gold and gem to pay rent for like 2 more months, but I don't know what I'm going to do after that. I mean, I guess find another dungeon to hack, but what are the odds that one will have more gold and gem than this one has? You know, I tell you, dungeons have really gone downhill lately. When I was your age, there were just piles of gold for the taking. But in this one, like, I occasionally find a gold coin. And that's it. I'm gonna lodge some serious complaints with the superintendent of this dungeon. I fought that thing too, right? Okay, so I have some sort of ion stone that's absorbing this thing's attack. I'm not sure what. It looks like magic missiles, but I can't be sure. I don't think there's an ion stone of magic missile absorption. So it might just be a different attack with a similar appearance. Dragon skin armor. Well, it's not magical, but it still might be better than what I have. Nope. And this was just crappy scale mail. There's no way. Yeah. Forget that stuff. All right. Well, that was a. What was that thing called? I know I killed a lot of them, right? No, or not. I don't know. See, there's no way I killed 55 of those scorpion things. These numbers are seriously inflated. That's so weird. What was that enemy I just killed? It wasn't a Spirinaga. It wasn't a... Oh, that was... Was that the Bone Naga? I guess it was. Well, damn. Still not quite sure. Ooh. Still not quite sure if I've reached the peak of this game's difficulty or not. Because those living mucks, those are something else. I hope I don't run into more of these in the future. Because holy crap. Come on, Hammer. I'm just going to very quickly fill out the rest of this map. And then, in this video. Level 17, booyah! See, I was worried that once the enemies started repeating the way they are, I was worried that my leveling days were over. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Okay, so the only thing I haven't filled out is this, and there's no way to get in there. Okay, I guess I'm done. Do I get anything cool for level 17? Probably not. I have another level 7 spell. Nice. I'll get another firestorm. Well, I don't need to do this right now. I'll go ahead and head down to level 12. We are two-thirds of the way done. Or at least we will be after this level, and drawing ever closer to whatever our goal is. Hope you guys are still enjoying the series. I'm still enjoying playing it, despite some of my belly aching. And yeah, I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye, everyone.